hour traffic has returned to Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia's biggest city. And more people are commuting again on the light rail. It could be something as simple as a haircut or a meal out. Malaysians are getting a chance to do more of the activities they used to take for granted.
I feel great about it, and right now one of the first things that I'm doing here is that after 3 months I'm out for a meal on my with my husband. And I haven't actually gone out in quite a while, so that's great.
The government is being credited for the movement restrictions for several months to contain the spread of COVID-19. But as life gets closer to normal, the country faces the significant toll on the economy. English teacher Jaswina Roy says she and her husband still have incomes, but many of their friends are not as lucky.
We know some people who've completely lost their jobs, who have got no earning power at all, and it's difficult because it's husbands and wife, and then they have kids, and then it's rent to pay and mortgages to pay, and there's no money coming in, and you know, it makes me worried. How would you sleep at night? How do they go about from their day-to-day activities, thinking and worrying about where the next paycheck is coming from?
Naveen Pillay just graduated from university with a degree in mechanical engineering. He has applied for about 20 jobs already, but says the competition is especially tight this year.
Yeah, there's more competition compared to, and also we have a fewer job applications being opened to all the fresh graduates.
In the month of April, we recorded 5% unemployment rate. That is the highest in the past 30 years. And we are seeing double-digit drop also in wholesale trade, which perhaps hints at the weak consumption pattern that we could be seeing for the rest of the year.
Researcher Lau Zhang Zhou says government stimulus measures are helping, but the country's dependence on tourism and oil is taking a toll.
The drop of the oil prices matter to the Malaysian economy, especially to the ability of the government to finance its operations, because a third of our fiscal revenue, our tax revenue, comes from petroleum-related sources.
Eric Chia, a construction cost engineer, says his income has dropped significantly since March.
It definitely will change my lifestyle, meaning to say there will be no vacation for this year and next year, I suppose, and there will be less eating out in the fancy restaurants. We used to go, like me and my wife, we used to go to a restaurant like maybe once a couple of months or a couple of 3 months, but now we hardly go to a fancy restaurant.
And these changes in people's patterns have rippling effects across the economy. So while Malaysians get another step closer to resuming their normal lives, their patterns of living often will not be the same. For VOA News, Dave Grunebaum, Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia.